And we have to determine field here at r vector. So second symbol has been used. Second symbol appears in the left of this equation, because we are calculating vector potential at position r vector. And m vector is magnetic dipole moment. Here r cap is vector and r square, it is scalar. R square is, this notation is scalar. Distance, it measures the distance between source point and field points. So here total magnetic field can be calculated using integral form of this expression. We are gathering all data. We are collecting vector potential of all dipoles. So this expression changes into a volume integral d tau prime. Now here we know that we can write gradient of a function equal to r cap by r square. We have discussed this expression many times. Then the gradient of 1 by r is equal to r cap by r square, and r cap by r square has been used here. Here this quantity is r cap by r square. So by putting the value of r cap by r square in this expression and using product rule is given in chapter 1, we find a expression which is a combination of two terms. Here it is first term and here it is second term. Both are volume integral. But we change the second term from a volume integral to a surface integral. And for making this change, we use Gauss divergence theorem. Here in this theorem, we replace force F vector by a new vector equivalent to F vector cross C vector. So by adopting this technique, we convert the second expression to a surface integral. So after this conversion, the first term gives you the volume bound current JV, and second term gives the surface bound current JS. So here this expression, first expression, here it is for JV, and here it is for JS, surface current or sheet current, that the current that flows at the surface of the materials. So here we have used a new technique to write a volume current JV equal to del vector cross M vector, and surface current KV equal to M vector cross M cap. So total vector potential using expression 6.13 plus 6.14, convert into mu 0 by 4 pi volume current and effective surface current by this expression. What this means, that total potential and also the field of a magnetized object is the same as would be produced by volume current. So here he is saying that total current is a combination of J, total current J vector, as is the vector, it is a combination of J free. I am writing here in this side J vector, it is a combination of J vector B plus J vector free current
AB
plus J vector, yes. So here total current is a collection of these three types of currents. Now Here we are going to discuss second term that is mentioned in your syllabus, auxiliary magnetic field. आज हम लोग auxiliary magnetic field के विषय में discuss करने वाले हैं. तो here field है, maybe of two types. First is we can light field. So here we are talking about magnetostatic fields, magnetostatic fields. So here it may be of two types. First is a magnetic field, which we call as real field or induction field, magnetic field, and it is denoted by a symbol B vector, and the unit of magnetic field is Tesla or Weber per meter square. You know these units, sir. The units are Tesla, denoted by symbol T, or Weber.
Weber per meter square.
And second field is auxiliary field.
IA.
Second field is auxiliary field. So here it is denoted by the symbol H vector. Now things will be clear more, and its units will be ampere per meter. So here the second field, here first field measures the strength of field at any magnetic object or at any magnetic poles. So here it measures and auxiliary magnetic fields it has the capacity to measure magnetization in material, and on this background we distinguish that materials is either a diamagnetic or para or ferromagnetic types. So here auxiliary it is used for measuring. It has capacity to measure magnetization. So as we do in case of electrostatics, in electrostatics here fields are also as two types. First is electric field, we have already discussed this, and second is displacement vector, T vector. And we adopt a technique to write total charge in electrostatics. Rho total. Rho represents total charge. Here rho is a symbol, and it is representing total charge, and it is equal to free charge plus bound charge. Here it is free charge. And Ruby is bound charge.
Bound charge.
And we use the same technique in case of magnetostatics to compute auxiliary magnetic fields. So here again, the fields are of two types. So here again, in case of auxiliary magnetic fields, in place of charge, we use a current density. So here we have two types of currents. First is bound current and second is surface current. So J vector total. It will be equal to J vector free plus J vector bound. Free current and here it is bound current. It gives it collects the information on second term, collects the information of bond current. And we know that JB, we have derived in previous class, JB vector, it is determined by del vector cross M vector. And we are ignoring the vector surface current KB vector here. It is equal to M vector plus MK. Yeah. So now we can write a left side in the form 1 by mu 0 del vector plus B vector from Ampere's law. And here it is equal to J vector equal to J free plus JB. JB we had derived in previous class. It is equal to del vector. Vector. So it will be equal to del vector plus M. Now collecting together the two cards. We have del vector. Now collecting it will be equal to del vector cross 1 by mu. Here it will be 1 by mu 0 B vector minus M vector equal to JF. So here the quantity inside this bracket can be given an handle name by the letter H vector. So the quantity is designed by the letter H vector. So we can write H vector is equal to 1 by mu 0 B vector minus M vector, where H vector is a auxiliary magnetic field.
Sir.
Hi. कौन बोल रहे थे? So sir.
ठीक है sir, admit करने का.
Here H vector is auxiliary मैग्नेटिक फील्ड। सो वी कैन डिटरमिन दैट एनी मटेरियल इज आइदर अ पैरा डाई और फेरोमैग्नेटिक बाय मेजरिंग एच वेक्टर। सो हियर वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट यूजिंग ए रीजन। सपोज here this box suppose is representing any material. So if we want to calculate p vector, magnetic field p vector through a surface ds, then it is equal to 5ia flux divided by area, because we know this expression p vector dot ds vector is equal to 5b. So now here H vector it collects the information of all magnetization in the material. So here it is predicting the capacity of magnetization in the material. Here S vector, it has same role in magnetostatics as a D vector in case of electrostatics. So we have